We're starting the brand new month and quarter with a Holy Week break. We are kicking off from $64.99, down 1% for the year so far, coming from gains of as much as 9% back in January. Let's get you set up for this shortened trading week. John Mangan, welcome to Market Edge. Good to see you. Hi, John. You're looking good. Are you wearing a barong?
Of course. It's Holy Week.
All right. Okay, so, John, after what you've seen in the first 3 months of 2023, would you call yourself a bull or a bear?
I'd call myself bored.
Why is that?
Well, because that's what the problem is. There's no excitement in the market. What the market is waiting for, if you want to know the honest truth, is the market's administration is boring and dull, all right, right now. It's been very reactionary, and there's nothing wrong with that. But what the market wants to see is some excitement. It wants to see a vision. It wants to see a roadmap. And we're not getting that from the administration. Fortunately for the administration, the opposition is a headless chicken. So what we're looking at right now is the market is waiting to see what's going to happen in the West with all their failing banks and the potential of that, what's going to happen in the Ukraine as Russia appears to be pushing forward. And as far as here in the Philippines, very, very stable and quiet. And markets want things a little bit more exciting. Mm-hmm. The only excitement we've seen in the last month is with Monday, and that was negative excitement.
John, if you think we're just waiting on news from the West, and if you are a believer that Asia is the bright spot and we will escape a recession, including the Philippines, then why are we falling this much, whereas Wall Street, where the recession is more likely, is on a roll? I mean, the NASDAQ just posted, what, its best quarterly gain since 2020?
Of course, because the Fed keeps pumping money into the economy. Mm-hmm. And look, the other problem here in the Philippines in terms of the stock market is the interest rate increases. Now, the interest rate increases have had small, medium, and large effects. Small effect on inflation, medium effect in terms of supporting the peso. But now those interest rate increases are starting to bite the corporate sector. If you notice, bank lending is down. And who's the biggest borrower from the banks? It's not you and I. We want a refrigerator. We either put it on zero interest credit card or we pay cash. It's the corporations that are borrowing, and corporations are not borrowing. I'm not talking about the San Miguel's and the big ones. I'm talking about small and medium-sized corporations are not borrowing right now because they figure at some point interest rates are starting to go down. So the interest rate increases are biting into the corporate sector, and in spite of the fact that profits are good, there's not a lot of money rolling around. That's what the situation is. And as far as what the NASDAQ and the NYSE does, it has no effect on the Philippines whatsoever, except a psychological effect. Whatever they're going to do over there with all that free, cheap money is fine and dandy. We have a little bit different situation here.
All right. So given that you say it's dull and boring here in Manila, do you expect this index to, you know, range trade? Is that the best?
Well, I'm looking at a potential move to up 200 points. I'm looking at a possible move down 200 points. Markets are not going down because of selling. Markets never go down because of selling. Markets go down because of buying, because there is always a constant supply of shares coming to the market for selling. The market prices move based on buying. If there's buying, prices go up. If there's no buying, prices go down. And that's why I say money is sitting on the sidelines right now, trying to figure out what they want to do. It's not waiting for the West per se.
Okay. And just before we go on that 5-day Holy Week break, we're going to get a March inflation print this Wednesday. Do you think it will show a second month of deceleration from February's 8.6%?
I think it's going to be down, but the news coming out today is an absolute disaster. And that's with oil prices, with Saudi and the Russians cutting production. You're looking at international markets immediately saw the price of Brent crude up 6.5%. Now it's leveled off a little bit. That's not good at all. And as far as inflation ticking down, look, a 0.2, 0.3% decrease or increase is, it's insignificant. My God, Pakistan is running 31% annual inflation. So a little bit, you know, the price of onions going up 2 pesos or 3 pesos is not significant. Mm-hmm. We are not, I don't think we've come over the hump of general inflation. And general inflation is not being caused by onion prices. It's being caused by companies raising prices to try to make up for the 2 years of lost revenues and profits.
Mm-hmm. All right. Some lots of things to think about there. Just very quickly, we're at the tail end of the earnings season. I wanted to get your take, because today, Macro Asia of the Lushotan Group, which handles catering for airlines, ground handling services, they returned to profitability last year. Profit there coming in at 461 million. Bottom line results contrasting to the net loss of 150 a year before. Just very quickly, earnings season for 2023, because that's a rearview mirror. When you look ahead, do you think earnings can keep up the momentum this year, or coming from a high base, it's most likely going to slow down?
Well, no, forget about bases and forget about 2021, 22, because what we have to do is we have to get back to pre-COVID lockdown situation. And I see good earnings for the rest of the year and going into 24, because as I say, prices have been increased, margins are back to where they were and even a little bit higher than pre-COVID. So I don't see any problem with earnings at all. I think earnings are going to continue to be good, except for those companies that are going to run into problems with the increased interest rates affecting their interest payments.
All right. John, we've come to the most exciting part of the conversation, your blind item. Talk to us about the stock that you're monitoring closely. Don't tell us, just describe. We're going to leave our viewers to guess what this is. What do you have for us today?
All right, I'm looking at a potential on this issue of about a 25% increase and about a 15 to 20% possible decrease. The Philippine DTI, along with agriculture, is pushing for New Zealand to import more products from the Philippines. This company has an operation selling bananas in Australia. And guess which country is the largest per capita consumer of Cavendish bananas in the world? New Zealand. So I think that that there's good potential for them to take advantage of it. And like I said, 20-25% upside potential, 15-20% downside potential. A lot of it's going to depend on the market.
All right. We're just going to have to guess which stock this is. John, pleasure speaking with you. Please do have a meaningful Holy Week break. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.